Hey guys, Barker Bears, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Atletico Madrid career mode. Where last time I left off, I picked up a win in the Copa del Rey against Villarreal, and I also beat them in the league. You know, nice double header. It was actually a triple header because between the first leg and this game, the second leg came up, and I won the tie 4-2. I simmed the second leg and lost it 2-0. So yeah. I still went through.
And this is the Vicente Calderon.
The next
today, Atletico Madrid will play Real Betis.
Copa del Rey tie. The first leg of that tie.
The 1982
second
stage in Spain. There were three games
first up
here
is Real
during
Betis
that tournament, and a concert from the Rolling Stones, which I was fortunate to attend. Are you in the front row? No.
You'll notice I've changed around the formation.
Diego Godin starts with Mir. Saved by the goalkeeper at full stretch.
Gone to the 4-3-3. And, you know,
they've got to defend it well.
Just want to see how.
That's a fine strike.
What comes from this, you know?
Well, when he's hit it.
Does this formation there suit? I don't know what it was. 4-2-2, it just wasn't working. You know? It just wasn't working.
Now Correa.
Now, people will probably say, oh, but, you know, you're playing with two strikers.
Excellent, the best in the division.
In your
the away record for
with,
the visitors
Origi and Mane.
Very, very
and,
bad.
Yeah, I am doing.
Find it hard, I think, to improve on that in this match.
Well, the way they've been created
it's
and
not
taken
clicking.
Their
it wasn't
the
clicking.
Team. I can only see one winner.
For this team. I don't know what it was. I wasn't happy with
that could pose some problems.
The amount. You know,
eye-catching save, well worth another look.
What I was getting out of my wingers, you know.
Cleared it well.
They were very isolated, I didn't notice them, you know. They briefly...
And he could get away here. In the clear here. And now the shot!
Pretty much become a non-factor. Well...
It was about that for composure. He's dropping his shoulder, rolling it into the bottom left.
And that has opened the score.
But yeah,
nil here.
I wasn't noticing
first.
Correa, I wasn't noticing that. I wasn't noticing.
Tried to tackle here, and he's done that.
Carrasco. And I wasn't noticing that. I wasn't noticing Felipe Anderson. The second. Team
Correa.
They end up going to it's still wrong with
saved by the goalkeeper at full stretch.
Strikers.
Goes for it with a fist.
I haven't made a decision on that yet.
Griezmann, he's kept it out.
Because I have a new signing who I signed between episodes. As you guys know, Jimenez wanted to leave.
Got there just in time.
What I did is, and it wasn't smart, I'm not gonna lie. I regret it. But you know, there's nothing I could do. I'd have to restart the whole career mode. Like, I don't even think I have auto save. I checked my all saves and
well, he has cleared the
none
danger.
Of them
this home team
works.
Unconquerable, home or away.
Cancelling.
Great work by the goalkeeper. The ball is his, and he's made sure he's protected.
Cancelling or not doing the thing. So it's signed, sealed, and delivered. I got a new player at the expense of losing Jimenez. Now, you're probably saying,
to get the equalizer. Griezmann.
I'm not gonna lie.
Even the team that have conceded it, I think, have recognized that they've been on the receiving end of much of this game.
He brought in this player. I probably could have gotten him for way cheaper. I probably sold him and as used a portion of what I would have gotten for him as to get the player that I got. I mean, I swapped him and as for this player, and basically I screwed myself. I mean, the player is good, but he's not an Jimenez in terms of rating and value. And yeah, it's just I kind of screwed myself over. You know?
Level,
which is scored
here now.
Sorry, just need a drink of water. So yeah.
Well, they've certainly had
and,
created more chances.
The player in question is Ian Acho from Manchester City. So
done well,
that's where Jimenez is.
It's a shot now!
Well, he's had a goal.
Well, you don't buy a ticket, as they say. And fair play to him for having a crack.
I'm pretty pissed that they cut through me so easily. Is that the first goal I've conceded this season?
Real threat from Atletico Madrid in these positions.
I've not been,
gone for goal.
Can see in many goals.
Wow, I was expecting it.
That's
to be
a real, that
there.
Goal earlier was a real disappointment. I was pissed.
Now Correa.
Silly goal again.
3 minutes from the referee by the fourth official. That's the decision
not to do
regarding
that.
Added time. Here's a chance to attack.
Control.
Here the challenge is a good one.
But yeah. Made a mistake. I'll hold my hands up. I'm not trying to, say. I don't want to sound like I'm bitching.
Possession level.
I made a mistake. I have to look.
They've made better decision.
And I will. My only thing is.
And they kick off. At the start of the
in the long run, I made a financial error. That was, that's the big story. You know, I mean, I could have easily gotten 30 to maybe 50 for Jimenez, and
there goes the cross.
Like 25 maybe for it would have cost maybe to get Ian Acho, depending on. Negotiation with Manchester City, because I think he's like valued at 18 million or something. I don't know if that's been affected by me purchasing him.
Patience is the name of the game at the moment.
To his valuation for sure. This guy is about 5 seconds away from getting his fucking
range. Pushing on, looking for the goal. We'll take them in front.
But yeah.
Trying to stretch the opposition.
I made a mistake. And
position here.
Just so it's clear, I did not make another mistake by not taking off Carrasco. He's going to play all
game. Just got the knack, hasn't he?
What's going to happen from now on, I'm going to give each player 90 minutes. One will play one game, and another will play the other.
Confidence to grab the second chance.
Unless it's a cup game, in which case...
Good luck here, again, by the replay of the goal.
Cup team will take... the rain. But yeah.
Off we go again. 2-1.
Thank you, Antoine Griezmann. He's me. You know what's funny? I'm recording this. The Madrid Derby was on today.
Well, to keep the ball.
Hey. And Antoine Griezmann got the goal that earned Atletico Madrid a point. Shame for Barcelona, they did nothing with it. And I mean, it was like a Liverpool match. I don't really like to mention Liverpool here, but It's almost exactly what you'd, as a Liverpool fan, it's almost exactly what you'd expect. What I'd expect Liverpool to do. Barcelona had the perfect chance to take hold of the La Liga title race. Real Madrid have a game in hand over Barcelona. This was the chance, because if Barcelona had won their game against Malaga and gone top of the table, when it comes to the El Clasico, but Barcelona would only have to win that match, win the Clasico, and Real Madrid's game in hand would matter. Then Barcelona would only have to keep winning. But surprise, freaking surprise, Malaga beat Barcelona 2-0, and Neymar got himself sent off. It was like, I was like, oh my god, this is hilarious.
Moving forward with some danger to the opposition, now they're here.
I said to my friend on Twitter,
well, now they're behind.
After that draw, I almost bet money on Barcelona dropping points against Malaga. He said, I'm going to put money on Malaga just in case. So he put, I don't know how much he put on him, but Malaga won. They won 2-0. Now, they scored the first goal before Neymar got sent off, and they scored the second one really late in the game, when it was probably over anyway. I mean, Barcelona, as good as they are, they're not even the best teams, will find it hard to get back into matches with 10 men. I mean, every team will would struggle in that situation, you know? Unless it's a situation where it's not going to really matter, like if the red card is late in the game and you're up, like say, like if you're, like if Barcelona had been winning 3 or 4-1 by the time Neymar had gotten sent off, it might not have mattered, because Malaga only scored one goal post the red card. But now, I didn't see the match, so I can't tell you that, oh, Malaga didn't, you know, they reset off or anything like that, because I don't know. Though I didn't get a chance to watch the Malaga game. I was too busy to watch the Atletico Madrid game, unfortunately, because Liverpool were on the telly, because of course they were. And once again, almost gave me a goddamn heart attack, but I'm not going to talk about that here.
It's good play until they got that challenge.
All I'll say is, this season better end soon, because it's going to kill us all otherwise.
Dangerously.
You know, if the world is destroyed beforehand.
Now he's a bit disappointed. He's going to be taken off here, and the manager may be saving him for another day, but also allowing him to get the full appreciation from the fans.
Well,
I don't think he wanted to come off.
The relief was relief. I was really.
And he scores. It's his third goal. It's a hat trick today. He's really been.
I was about ready to have a fucking ambulance on standby. I mean,
what a day he's
having. One of these days they are gonna kill me. Which is,
the opposition all match, and he's
sad, but unfortunately, it's probably true.
4-1 is the scoreline. We're hearing the will.
Anyway,
minutes here.
On to back to La Liga. Really, that loss to Malaga pretty much makes me think Real Madrid are winning La Liga this season. Because with their game in hand, Barcelona would have to hope that Real Madrid lose their game in hand. Because Real Madrid were already 2 points ahead before today, so that point now gives them a 3-point advantage. Even if Real Madrid do lose their game in hand, whoever it's against, I don't know. Well, I think they have a game in hand because they were in the thing. Or, were they? Yeah, they were, because they won the Champions League last season. So they would have been in the Club World Cup.
Remember, 5-1.
Good. Yeah, so they won it, didn't they? But yeah. Real Madrid have a game in hand because of that. Sure.
Different kind of game to the one. The
same situation Man United were in a few seasons ago. After they beat Chelsea in the 2009-10 season. I mean, after they beat Chelsea the past year in the final. You guys. Real Madrid, with that game in hand, Real Madrid have the league title race by the balls. I'm sorry to be so graphic, but that's the way it is.
La Liga.
Real Madrid will have to massively fuck up not to win the league from here.
Las Palmas.
Because, I mean,
Celta de Vigo, nil.
How likely are Real Madrid to drop points again this season?
At the top of the table remain Atletico Madrid.
I'm gonna go with not very.
With a game in hand on the team below.
Yeah, not very.
Rising up the table are Barcelona with 31 points.
I'm trying to be, as
Villarreal with
blunt and as with a game in hand. Honest as I can.
Fourth, moving down,
I think it's
with 29 points.
It's well known that out of the two, I prefer in fifth. Or Barcelona, but I'm going to be perfectly honest, Real Madrid, if they do not win the league this season, they will have fucked up, because it's in their hands, it is, and that is down to Barcelona. Real Madrid might want to cut Malaga a nice big check saying, here you go, thank you very much for being Barcelona that weekend. And really did us a solid. Especially after Atletico Madrid fucked up our evening earlier in the day. So, you know, thanks. Here's some money.
With 18 points. With a game in hand on the team above.
I could see them doing that. I could really see them doing that. That's not at all far-fetched in my mind. Whatsoever. So, get some players onto the pitch. Get some fresh legs, and there you see Iheanacho. Proof that he is now a Atletico Madrid player. Wait, what? Oh, Alexis Sanchez. I was gonna say. When I saw Sanchez, I was like, wait, what? Thinking it was Renato. That would be a fucking headline-grabbing transfer, wouldn't it? Borussia Dortmund signed Renato Sanchez from Bayern Munich. After all the times Bayern Munich say, he's good, we'll take him from Borussia Dortmund. Because they've done it with pretty much every good Borussia Dortmund player except for Marco Reus.
For the Spanish Cup, we are now.
I mean, they got Mario Götze. Yeah, after a few disappointing seasons, he went back. They took Lewandowski.
Temptingly close to the final.
And recently they took Kovacic. because whatever, I'm fucking, well, let me fuck not. And
a few changes for Atletico Madrid. Andre Moreira is the goalkeeper.
Someone said to me the other day,
together with Luciano Vietto,
Bayern Munich will probably sign Moussa Dembele in a few seasons once Ribery has retired. He said he doesn't think with some danger.
Stopped emphatically and just as well. The approach play looked very encouraging.
Thomas Muller will get a lot of minutes. I mean, Muller doesn't get a lot of minutes at Bayern anyway, apparently. You know, because when he came on against Arsenal, the commentator said that his game time has been limited this season. And, I mean, that's a shame. That is an absolute shame, because Muller is a really good player.
It's a quick break.
I mean,
terrific stop. Shots on here. Shot blocked here.
When you hear the rumors that Muller is almost every transfer window, it's like, oh, where's Thomas Muller going? People are waiting for him to move. Oof.
Thiago! Too high.
And
over the crossbar.
That limited game time, that will pile up. Thomas Muller is actually a player I'm looking at possibly signing a career mode. I mean, I would have gotten him in this one, but I said, nah. I like the strength of my main team as it is. Like, I might have signed him if someone wanted to leave and there was, like, nothing I could do. Like, say if Antoine Griezmann had handed in a transfer request. Although, I'm not gonna lie, if Griezmann had, I would have replaced him with Aubameyang. You know, replace that pace with more pace. That's the way to do it, my friend. That is the way to do it.
Probing away.
But Thomas Muller is definitely someone I want to use this FIFA.
And Thiago.
Like, if you guys remember, a few FIFAs ago, I used Thomas Muller, or I made him a god among men in a Liverpool career mode. I think that was actually, yeah, that was FIFA 50. That was FIFA 15. Or was it FIFA 14? No, it was FIFA 15. It was FIFA 15. I made him a god among men. I said, you know what, I'll use different players in FIFA 16. I could have easily brought Muller back. I could have easily. No. I used different players in FIFA 16. I didn't even play with Muller or all that much in FIFA 16. I briefly used him in Ultimate Team. And when I went to Germany, I didn't get put with Bayern Munich. And my, you know, I didn't want to spend all my budget by bringing in Thomas Muller and just. None of the. That's. In the end, I never went with him. I never used him. Give me a few. So, you know, maybe the. I don't know what the future holds in terms of career modes. I mean, my next one could be Bayern Munich.
They've linked up well.
We shall see. It will be a very interesting time in the panel of FIFA 17. We will see what the future holds in terms of future career modes once this one is over. I mean, this one's flying by. I mean, we're already in January.
Now it's Kelechi Iheanacho. Atletico Madrid now.
You know, having a lot of extra games in, like, the Copa del Rey and the Champions League. gonna slow me down just a little bit, but all in all, by the time FIFA 17's cycle is over and we get geared up for FIFA 18,
trying to switch
and you might think, oh, Corey, that's a long ways away. We're in April. It's like 4 months. If you think 4 months won't fly by, it will. It very much will. Because, I mean, it feels like yesterday.
That's that special buzzer.
Was January 1st. The year is already flown by.
Especially maybe here in Spain.
Today is the 8th of April, 2017. It is already the 8th of April. The 8th of April.
Atletico Madrid throw.
And I mean,
no wasting time here.
I don't know what else to tell you guys.
Maybe a sight of goal. And here's the shot. Oh, that's great work by the goalkeeper.
Time is ticking away like nobody's business.
Club involved. It's Juventus who've made this signing.
Well, it's a fairly big transfer figure, £40 million.
There are career modes still to be done.
I think this lad won't be affected by it, though. He'll be able to concentrate on his football and show us.
Yeah, we'll see what happens. We will see what happens. I mean, sure. Not just the Bundesliga hasn't been done yet. I haven't been to Italy.
Session's gone away.
Of all the big leagues, I've won league, and I'm halfway through Serie A. But Bundesliga and Calcio, I've not been there yet.
This attack very well into a quite a dangerous position now. And Thiago.
Which is weird because normally I would have done. Normally I would start with all the big leagues, which is weird. But having the wheel, having my wheel decider, having wheeldecider.com choose what is next for me, has been, you know, it's been an interesting experiment, which I don't see any reason to stop, because I'm having a blast. Having not knowing what you're going
to, like, and now the shot!
And I've been asked before, when do I pick? When do I pick the next career mode? When is it? I will wait until I have officially won the league. That's because that's normally the sign that the career mode is reaching its end. Is when the league has officially been won. That's when I will pull up the wheel, spin it around, and always two spins, and one to decide the league, and the second spin will decide the team. And that's, ladies and gentlemen, is how and when I choose who's, or my next career modes have been decided. So,
well, Betis in their next match in La Liga, and I do see them as strong favourites. I think they'll win.
When it, the difficulties of going from when defending when you know it's when it comes up and
to get the team going again as an attacking force.
Let's say maybe give it like
here's a chance.
6-7 episodes maybe.
It's another goal.
Depending on I have to account for Champions League fixtures and Copa del Rey fixtures. Maybe 6 or 7, 8. Maybe, depending on other results as well. It'll be a few episodes, anyway, before I next have to pick my margin here to two. The next career mode has to be picked.
8 more minutes
is what I'm getting at. But yeah, that's
it's gonna be a substitution.
Someone did ask me if a fan could pick, like if they could pick my next career mode. I've done a fan one before and I didn't enjoy it because the fans
attacking power in this situation.
They I did it really early when I didn't have a lot of subscribers. And I got stuck with Manchester United. You guys remember back when I was recording the screen with my laptop webcam? Back when that was what I did before I got my Elgato, and visual and audio quality was terrible. I mean, look at that. Look, this is clear as day. Go back and watch some of my earlier videos. Yeah, it's cringe, even for me.
Success here is the whistle blows.
And you know, it's hard for someone to critique their own work because you always want to say the best things about you. I am a strong belief that if you don't like what you put out, how do you expect other people to? That's what I believe, anyway. And that actually was taught to me by a good friend of mine who always had who that's his like go-to phrase. He's a painter, but you know he hasn't made big he hasn't like put any art out there to be bought or anything like that, because he always says if you don't like what you produce, if you don't like it, no one else will like it. You have to like your own stuff. You have to look at it and say, would I enjoy this? And to be honest, I completely understand that I was in my stuff. Well, my early stuff was terrible. It was, like I said, it was cringe. It was absolutely cringe. But luckily, I got over that. I got my Elgato when it wants to work, and yeah, I got my mic, which I have to say has really improved my sound quality. I think I sound much more clear. And my friends agree I do sound clearer. So, you know, improving what you put out makes it seem better to other people. And that's the and well, someday I will probably, I might want to do another situation where I let a fan, let you, who my fans, my subscribers pick my career routine, but I'll have to put certain clamps on it because I'm not playing as Manchester United again. That's not happening. So, glad I could clear all that up. Next episode, I'll have a game against Athletic Bilbao and the second leg against Real Betis, Gijón. I'll have the second leg in the quarterfinal against Gihon. Because we head to the end of the January transfer window. Until then, thanks for watching. I'm Joy. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new to the channel. Or when you enjoy the content so you don't miss future uploads. Click on the bell to get notifications because YouTube be fucked up. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Until then, goodbye.